something that'll make you scream. Ugly people be quiet is the name of the theme. So listen to this tune, don't knock it till you try it. People, ugly, ugly people, will you please be quiet?
Yeah, it's like that, Anna. Yeah, yup, it's like that, Anna.
The main squeeze of the airways is about to explode!
Coming in with the rhyme and set it off for those soft. Looking at the front door at main source. Who be
Yo, I want y'all to know this, yo. When hip hop first started, it was all about the DJ spinning wax back to back. This is hip hop. This is the raw, real form of hip hop. What you see right here, spinning motherfucking wax on the wheels of steel. This is hip hop right here. You know what I'm saying? Hey, yo, I want y'all to know this, yo. When hip-hop first started, it was all about the DJ spinning wax back to back. This is hip-hop. This is the raw, real form of hip-hop. What you see right here, spinning motherfucking wax on the wheels of steel. This is hip-hop right here. You know what I'm saying?
You're in the mix with the old-school guru, DJ Kid Disco. Get a move.
DJ Kid Disco on the wheels of steel. On WGBF Thunder Beat.
Definitely excellent up. But I must say, I'm actually not the founder. I'm the executive producer. But I did not, I was not the founder. Ed Box Brunson was the founder.
Well, educate us.
Yes, Ed Box. He was the founder of Urban Expressions back in 1992.
Word.
Yes, and then I came along and did my thing.
So, well, when did you come in? Like 93, 94?
I want to say 94, I believe, 94, 95. I was always around, but just not working in the, you know, just not working on it.
Oh, okay. But you waited the time. I was like Jennifer Lopez waiting to get down with the Living Color. You just hung around until it was your time to shine.
No, I just was chilling, you know. I was like, yeah, I don't know about this show here. I'm saying it wasn't my thing at the moment, but then it became my thing.
Word.
Let me tell you how much it was your thing. I can remember coming from the club. I can remember, there was so many that we was at back in the day, Frank.
Came back from gig.
And the only time you could catch Urban Expressions was like 1 a.m, but nobody played the hip hop stuff that Shelly was playing. MTV didn't play that. Urban Expressions played
the underground.
Yeah, the underground stuff. And back then, we talking Dos Effects and Keith Murray and
Smooth the Hustler.
She was playing that. Urban Expression was playing that stuff that you wasn't getting on MTV. You wasn't. It wasn't a watered down version. It was a straight. You know.
But then also Disco, we gotta give her props for this too. Her and the whole team at Urban Expressions, they gave us local talent. They went to where all the local talent was at. I seen some live freestyles on there. I seen cats I knew that was trying to make it on there. You know, and that was big, you know, because it wasn't too many outlets for Philly entertainers, MCs or DJs at that time. But Urban Expressions did give everybody that shine. And it wasn't territory. Like it didn't matter if you was from North or South or West or G-Town or Uptown or Frankfurt. It didn't matter. If you was hot and they heard about you and they thought you was worthy, they put you on the show. So that's up for that.
Some of it was just you got money. So we got to be real. You know what I'm saying? Okay. I ain't going to sit there and lie. Some of it was hot, and some of it was what you got. Show me what you got,
Jonah.
Yeah, word.
So Shelly, you know I'm old, so ooh. I kind of remember the story. Can we talk about it in detail? The numerous times that we were, you know, down there in Kensington, blasting off. I think Keith was still there. Yeah, Keith was still there.
I think at the time when we were down in Kensington, it was Rockstar P. It was the new generation. It was Rockstar P. We were doing it at the time. It was Put You On Studio, which is now Family Printing. So they took out the whole thing and gave us a whole studio to do Urban Expressions live. You know,
yeah, we did. And we had some fun.
We did have fun.
We had a lot of fun. Shout, first of all, since she couldn't be here, shout out to the Philly Wonder Woman, Bible Princess. She got so many names.
She got a bunch of names. That's okay. That's right.
But let me
tell y'all,
you need that many names.
Let me tell y'all a real quick story of how me and Shelly even got together, because Shelly had no clue who I was. And she was looking for a DJ at the time. And, you know, my bestie looking out as she did. What about this dude, Kid Disco? I don't know him. Well, I recommend. She's like, all right, I'll give him a call. Frank, I'm not lying. About 2 days later, I get a phone call. Is this Kid Disco? Yes. Who this? You know me. Who this? This is Shelly Williams. Shelly Williams. Urban Expression Shelly Williams? Yeah, Lucinda recommended you. Would you like to DJ my... Click, I'll be down there in 5 minutes.
I'm surprised you ain't get there quicker.
Well, and here's the funny part. It was all history because for some reason my van wasn't working at that time. And it just so happens, another legend, Astro Funk alumni, drove me down there. DJ Easy T.
Mm-hmm.
First okay. time, remember that Shell? Tone came in there, was like, you're Shelly Williams.
Oh, yeah.
Are you the?
Well, Shell, what was it like from your perspective? What was it like for you meeting Kid Disco for the first time?
Meeting Kid Disco, you know, he was funny. Very colorful. A lot of personality. But I knew we were going to have some fun, which we did.
Word.
He had his history. I know he know his music. He know his stuff.
Yeah, he knows some music now. I gotta give him credit on that.
Listen, so, it was such a pleasure to hang out with Shelly I mean, I knew she was the queen of Philly, but I didn't know she was like that. You walk in with Shell. Oh, go ahead. Wait, you don't want to stamp my hand? No, you well.
Yeah, right. It ain't that deep.
Okay.
I remember Jazzy made a cake, man.
Yeah, shout out to Jazzy. Yeah, at the birthday party.
Yeah, she made the cake. Oh, the cake is good.
Who's V's
daughter? Nah. Cindy's goddaughter. We
okay, Jazzy Cakes.
Yeah, it was.
That's it.
Yeah, I remember her. Yeah,
it was a birthday party at the Champagnes uptown, and it was me, K Swift, and Perry P. It was our birthday. Everybody came out.
I think I was there that night. Cause you know I used to work at Champagnes.
We was upstairs.
It had the red lights on, and Perry P. I was there that night. That was the first one y'all threw after.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I was there that night.
Yep. So, Shell, finish telling us your. First of all, I want to know. I want to go back into Urban Expressions, and I want to know exactly how that process works. How does somebody get a video played? Back in those days.
Back in those days, to get a video play, well, the national videos, you know, the regular record company, they sent the video. So whenever a new video comes in, it was sent in the mail, and that's how you got a video through the mail, because we were on the system. And so every time it came, we got all the videos. Anybody that was out, any new video, anybody new hot. New hot songs, we got it. It was in the mail. That's how it is. But locally, pretty much you send it in. Still same way. Email it. You can't do that. Back then, you had to mail it. So back then, you would mail it in, or we would meet up for something like that. They might be able to come by the studio. Whatever it was, that's how it is. But that's what happened. That's how you get it. You got to be hot.
Okay.
Sometimes you're not hot. Gotta have money. You know? Sometimes you MC whack and you got some dollars. It's all good.
Well, let me ask you this. Who was your actual first co-host of the show?
The first, like I said, Ed Box Brunson started the show. His co-host was Roz. Chilling with Ed and Roz. Urban Express. So Ed and Roz were the first hosts.
Okay.
Then it was Keith from up the block.
Okay.
He had a few co-hosts.
Right. Well, I have to say this though. The chemistry between you and Keith, it was like that. It was comedic. It was real. It was like a, when I say love affair, I don't mean like an intimate love affair, but it was like the chemistry between you guys was just like on point. Like, did you guys know each other before that, or you just got together at that situation and the magic just happened, as they say?
It just happened. I didn't know anybody except for Ed beforehand. My sister Monty on the scene, which is her birthday at 12 midnight, her birthday, but she's the one that...
Wait, that's your sister?
Huh?
Monty on the scene is your sister?
Yes. So,
oh, snap.
She was the one that was coming to Urban Expressions. She was dedicated. She would come every week. And because back then we lived up in the Northeast, she was like, come on, just take a ride with me. Ride with me. I'm like, I don't want to go to that show. It's whack. I don't feel like doing that. She's like, come on, we got all this long ride. Ride with me. So week after week, I would go with her and just sit there like, yeah.
Where's the fun in this, huh?
Because you know, we were the first live show, a live video show. So everything was live. So it was happening at that moment. So when people's giving their shout outs, you know, hey, this is Boo Boo. I want to give a shout out to my girl, my boo, blah, blah, blah. That was all live. So we had people on the phone. It was like a phone bank. So you had the phone, people on the phone answering the phones. Ooh. And then you write down the message and you run it in there because they're live on the air.
Yeah.
The message in there. So that's what they were doing every week. And I was just like, yeah. And you know, I'm real saved sanctified, like, oh, this is the devil's music. I ain't about this life. but one night, because it is live, I think everybody called out except for one person on the phone. And he was the one person who was like, can you help me? And it was Sco. I don't know if you remember Sco. He was on the word on the street. But Sco was like, can you help me? I was like, nah, I can't help you. And then he came back again. Like, I really need help. Can you help me? I said, nah, I can't help you. And then by the third time, I thought about how nice. That's not even nice. It's not nice to not help somebody. And he asked me again, can you help? And I was like, all right, let me help. So let me take over once I help. So once I help, I took over. And that's how I started, pretty much. I'm like, all right, well, we got to do it this way. You want to get this done, it got to be done right. We're going to do it this way, that way, this way, you know.
Oh, so you micromanage, huh?
No, I just, you know, want to do things differently.
Okay. So, go ahead, Dico.
I got a question for you, Shelly.
What's that question?
Out of all the... I'm great, put you on the spot.
Oh.
Out of all the artists that you've had over the years, live, video, I'm going to say live, in the 90s, because that's pretty from my recollection where Urban Expressions was really like just killing the game. My question to you is, what artists stood out the most? Not just Philly, I'm just saying, period.
What do you mean by stood out the most? You mean the one I liked the most?
That you just knew.
No, I want to know that. I was going to ask that one.
That you just knew that they was going to blow up.
I knew that they were going to blow up. Jay-Z, of course. Jay-Z, I had to really think back. I never even thought about it like that, who I knew was going to blow up. Most of the time, by the time they got to us, they already had a name, but Jay-Z came out with that, ain't no nigga, you know what I'm saying? He came out with that, and that was like his first one, and it was basically just climbing the charts at that moment, but, I couldn't understand that song. I mean, I understand it, but you know, coming from a religious background, and you got a song talking about ain't no like the one I got sleeps around. You know, I couldn't understand that song. I was just like Jay-Z, Mr. Jay-Z. He was just starting out. He had no major bling or nothing. His chain was like a little chain. He was, he was normal, a little laid back. He didn't look like a superstar at that moment. And I was like, Jay-Z, listen, what kind of song is that? Talking about sleeping around and giving you a lot. You gonna get, somebody gonna get some STD or something. I said, what you should be doing is promoting safe sex and handing out condoms. And so he decided, all right, man. He was like, Mom, this is real. This is what happened, Mom. This is what happened. You know what I mean? That's real, Mom. And I'm like, I hear you, but you need to, promote safe sex. But at his next show, he did have some condoms and handed them out. That's my Jay-Z story.
Right on. I got two questions I have to ask. Well, really three. So I heard you mention earlier that it'll be your sister's birthday tomorrow.
It is her birthday, April 17th. Yay!
All right, it's her birthday. When is your birthday?
My birthday is January 20th.
Oh, okay. And I also heard you mention the Northeast. Where are you from?
I am from Frankfurt. Frankfurt.
What? Margaret and Orthodox Folk Ride Street?
Up that way. You know Frankfurt, huh?
A little something.
You know Frankfurt.
That's where Disco Rat is from.
Who?
Disco Rat.
I don't know Disco Rat, but hey, Disco Rat. I'm probably do know him, but
okay. From Frankfurt. He from Frankfurt.
What's up, Frankfurt?
Disco Rat is like the Grandmaster Flash of Philly.
I know I heard his name. I probably definitely know him. And if he's from Frankfurt, I was born and raised in Frankfurt.
I'm surprised I haven't ran into you. But then I also wanted to ask you during the 90s, because fly as you are, pretty as you are, still got your real hair and all that good stuff.
I got my real hair today. I had a weave in last week and I had to take it out because the salons are closed, but
Believe me, I know. But I want to say this. I know it had been a lot of guys crushing on you, right? Mm-hmm. Who did you know was crushing on you? And then I would ask, with all the guys back then, who did you have a crush on? Celebrity-wise.
Celebrity-wise, nobody. Nobody had a crush on me. I was business. All business, 100%. I didn't play. All business.
I ain't trying to hear that. Listen, somebody had to try and get in your ear.
No, fact.
Nobody tried to get in your ear?
No, all business. And if somebody had a crush on me, maybe they should tell me now, but I don't think so. Holla at me. I don't know, no. And I didn't have a crush on any celebrity. Well, I did. This one group, y'all probably won't even remember this group. It was called Chris John. It was two boys came out on Jay-Z's label, Rockefeller, singing boys, R&B boys. Now they came out. I was like, yes, I want to interview them every time they come to Philly.
Chris Johnson. I don't even recall them. They were on
Rockefeller. They had the song "Watching My Life Go Down."
Right. Known Rockefeller for rappers. Not.
But they made that song was hot. They didn't make it. They made it.
I don't understand if it's a hot song and now you don't have me, YouTube it and check it out. And what was the name of it again?
The name of the group was Chris John. It was like Christian, but Chris John with a little accent. And the song was "Watching My Life Go Down." That might not be the exact title, but if you put in "Watching My Life Go Down," it'll pop up.
Well, YouTube is good for that. Watching My Life Go Down.
Come up every now and then. I'm YouTube and to hear it in my ear. Watching my life go down.
Let me find out you got a poster.
No, I ain't no poster, but I do got my pictures. You know, every now and then I do go back to my pictures and remember. And today, today on my Throwback Thursday, I posted the Brat. Her birthday was on the 14th.
Yeah, today Cool Herc's birthday.
Cool Herc, oh my goodness!
Yeah, today is birthday. Tomorrow is actually Grandmaster Caz's birthday.
Okay, I don't think I have a picture with either one of them. I should have one of Herc, but I don't know. I don't know where that one is.
Well, I tell you what, you should once this epidemic is over, pandemic is over, you should ride with us up to New York.
Oh, let's go. We're New York bound.
Hey. Yeah. I love hanging out there. I love Harlem. You know, I got a lot of good brothers in the BX, you know, and I hang with a lot of the first generation stars.
The first generation stars?
Yeah, the first generation of hip hop. I